Welcome to a Field Trip Toolbox video. You can visit us at fieldtriptoolbox.org.
Welcome to the Field Trip tutorial where we learn how to use the Structure I/O sensor to localize LA to a position. First of all, we have to prepare the subject. We firstly mark the fiducials on the right ear, like this. Then we go to the nose, mark between the cavity on the upper part of the nose, like this. And then we go to the other ear and mark again the fiducial like this. Then we start using the 3D scanner. First of all, we have to specify the bounding box we want to measure. This is too big, a little bit smaller. This is good, so we press scan and start. The distance between me and the subject is roughly 1 meter. We can slowly walk around the subject and measure it. You can see me in between, I'm stopping. This time the device takes a picture frame and for the coloring. After roughly 180 degrees around the subject, I start to lift the iPad above the subject to also measure the upper part of the cap, like this. When I'm done with this, I go down and also measure the facial parts, so we also have this part included in our data set. You can see on the device the white space, which looks like a statue, that's the part we actually measured of the subject. When we're done, we can directly do a quality check. We can see if we have everything as it should be. See, also go to the back part, it's good quality. Also the hair is good. You can see on the upper part, it's a little bit messy. It's just the image, not the structure data. This is one nicely fiducial. Then we go to the nose. It's also again, we nicely captured this fiducial. When we're done, we can press send. I'll go to the email. Type in the email address we want to have it sent to, and here it is, we press send. So now we have the data on our PC. So we start MATLAB, and with MATLAB we firstly add field trip to our working path, and then we load the actual structure I/O model. Just like this, then we can rotate again to see this is the same data set as we saw in the previous part of this video. Again, do a quick quality check if it satisfies you. After that, we mark the fiducials on the subject. Therefore, we have to take again the rotate tool, make it bigger so we can better see the subject's data set. Rotate it. Oh, there we pressed it. We have to press R to remove this electrode. Then we click on the nose, hold the click, and then we can rotate it to see if the other fiducials. Then we click again, hold it, rotate to the other side of the head, click again on the fiducial. After this, we press Q to finalize it. The next step, we co-register the 3D scan into the CTF coordinate system. Again, we can nicely see how the axis goes directly to the fiducial where we clicked them. Marking fingers, that we can see the x-axis, the back part, goes below the cap, which is not what we expected. Next thing we do is localize the electrode positions. Again, for this we make the device bigger. Then we firstly rotate to the head where we want to start. Press R again to remove it, then we click in the middle, and then we can click one by one the electrode positions. Now I speed up the process and you can see how I did it quickly and rotate it and click. And you have to click in the specific order that you want to have it, because now the first electrode you clicked is the first in the data set, and the last one you click is the last one in the data set. Now we can actually see how we localize the electrodes. The black spots are the ones where we clicked, and when we rotate it, you can see the electrodes are nicely aligned to the head where the electrodes are. Again, we can rotate to see better. And if you're happy, you can leave the data set. If you're not happy, you can just do it all over again. So next thing we can also do is see the labeling and check labeling. For this case, we use the EasyCap M10, so the ordering scheme is like 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on to the 61 electrode. And we also have the fiducials, the grounding, and the reference. Here we can also check again for errors if something is labeled wrong or we just missed something, but it doesn't seem like that. One thing you might realize is that we clicked onto the cap, but actually an electrode would not onto the electrode cap, but actually touching the surface. So what we do now is we move the electrodes inward inside the head. Now we can't see them, but if we rotate it, you can see that every electrode has moved 6 millimeter inwards. That's roughly the thickness of the electrode where we would clip it in. So that would be it. Thank you.